Now, we're going to sing Silent Night, and the words will be up on the screen in a minute, but I found a new arrangement of it, and I tried it out on Jonathan, and that's what he did. So, but I think it saves some time on Silent Night, okay, because it goes like this. Silent night, holy night, always calm, always bright, round yon virgin mother, a child asleep, in heavenly peace. You see, we could get the whole thing done, all four verses, and just all in favor of that. There's two votes, all opposed. Yeah, okay, let's sing the regular version then. Would you please, ladies? Silent night. Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender. Stand, if you would, on the last verse, please. Silent night, holy night, wondrous star, let thy light with the angels let us sing. Christ the Savior is born. Father God, in Jesus, we thank you for the eternal hope that we have, because you sent a young baby, your son, who left his throne of glory behind the riches and safety of heaven to take on the form of a man, to be a sacrifice, a blood sacrifice for me and for each of us here. God, I give you praise and glory for the blessings that you give us. And Lord, as we move through this season, help us not to hurry it like that first song of Silent Night, but help us to move through in an observing way to the folks around us, to live Jesus, because the light of him is in us. We sang about that light, Lord. Let that light so shine for each and every one. I ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Pastor.
All right. Good evening, folks. We are going to have a wonderful time tonight. Are you looking forward to this evening? We were so blessed in our morning service to hear our boys and girls sing. And you're going to get a taste of really a full serving of the work that they put into this presentation. So welcome. Let's take an opportunity really quick, if you would, to stand to your feet. And because it's flu season now, just turn and give a verbal greeting to those around you right now. And we'll get ready for our offering.
Father God, we just can't thank or praise you enough for your promise long ago after Adam and Eve fell. Father, you came and you spoke when you spoke to the serpent, Satan, Father, and told him you'd be enmity between his seed and her seed, Father, meaning Jesus. And we knew that Jesus would step on his head and have victory at the cross. And we thank you for this time of season, Father. We celebrate the birth of Jesus. And we thank you for this night where we have the children of this church celebrate you, Father. And we just pray that you bless each one of these young lives, Father, not only tonight, but throughout their lives, Father, as they grow. And let them grow in you, Father. For the offerings, we're thankful for all you give to us. And, Father, we thank you for allowing us to give our offerings and tithes back to you so that we can use them for your glory as your direction. I ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you for coming, and just we'd like to share, you know, just Jesus with you tonight. And we want to be children, don't we? We want to be like we're in the presence of Jesus because he's here. Did you know that? Yes, boys, he is here. And girls, yes, Jesus is here. So we want to sing for him tonight, don't we? And honor him, yes. I have one change that I want to make. Jaden Lewis, a soloist in Away in a Manger, will be sung by Savannah tonight. So, thank you.
Rain upon Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Jesus. I'm so glad it's Christmas. All the tinsel and lights and the presents are nice, but the real gift is you. Happy birthday, Jesus. I'm so glad it's Christmas. All the carols and bells make the holiday swell, and it's all about you.
Bye.
All right. Listen, while you're still standing, last year I did something real special, and I thought we would do it again in closing out our program tonight. Have all the boys and girls, if you would please, boys and girls, come and stand down here. Moms and dads, grandparents, if you're here, tonight, I want you to come stand with your children right here in the altar, and we're going to do a prayer of blessing on these children, but I want your parents, grandparents to assemble. Come on down here, guys. Go and stand with your moms and dads and your grandparents, grandma. Do that right now. We're going to assemble right over here, and we're going to do a prayer blessing. There we go. All right. While they're assembled here, everybody else out there, in just a minute, I'm going to have you join in with me in a very symbolic way. But let me say right now to the moms and dads, the grandparents that are here with your kids, what a blessing this day it was. I know it is for you, for sure, to hear your boys and girls sing the songs that they prepared and practiced, but also the blessing they are to our lives. Huh? If you're a mom and dad, grandparent, you know what a blessing, what a treasure these children are, a gift from God indeed. So everybody out there, if you would extend your hand in their direction right now as a symbol of your prayers for them, and I'm going to lead a prayer right now. While I pray, moms and dads, if you're up here, grandparents, I want you to pray, okay? And we'll ask God a special blessing on these children during this holy day season. Heavenly Father, we do stand in awe of your creative ability. Father, you made us so unique. You made our children, grandchildren, so special, so unique. Father, they're gifts that we have, that you've given us and entrusted their lives to us for a very short time while they're still children, young adults, till that time where as adults they step out into the world, Father. You give us this chance to prepare them well. Lord, these moms and dads and grandparents have invested in the lives of their children by being part of this church, by sending them to be a part of a program just like the one, Father, we witnessed here and experienced tonight. We know these songs and the memories will stay with the moms and dads. Songs, many of them, lyrics will stay in the hearts and minds of these boys and girls. Bless them, Father, I pray. Richly, greatly, in Jesus' name, amen. 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 Give him a hand out there again, okay? Thank the Lord for him. I'm going to ask Melissa to come back up here. Come here, Melissa. Come on back up here if you would. Now, you may be seated, family. I know right after the program, we have some special refreshments. But before we go there, I just want to say a few words here. If you'll take a seat and let me just say a few words of thanksgiving for Melissa and for her team. If you've been a part of the church for a long time, you know just how very blessed we are to have Melissa here at Myrtle Grove Baptist Church. And her investment in the lives of children, her passion and love for God shines all over her face, all over her expression. We are so proud of you. Melissa, I want to give you this opportunity to recognize some of your workers with you here.
Yes, without my helpers or workers and fellow teachers, I would really have a hard time. So I'm just thankful for them. So I'd like for them to come up here. Tanya Caro, Margaret Shields. Oh, Margaret's not here. That's right. Jennifer Fanugo, Carla DeJesus, Scott Gerald. Good. And Glenda Fillingham, yay. Thank you so much, guys. Let's give these guys a hand. Thank you so much. Yes. I really appreciate all these that have been helping me through the year, and just each one has a specific thing that they help me with, and I'm just really happy to have them. So thank you, guys.
Thank you, Melissa.
All right.
Thank you.
Be praying for Margaret's, I think it's, what's his name?
Kenny.
He's in the hospital, so just be praying for him. Or he's not in the hospital, but he's emergency room. So that's why she's not here. So she would have been here. Okay. Thank you.
Very nice.
I want to thank all the parents, all the folks that came out tonight. We do have some refreshments in the fellowship hall right after we close in prayer. I'm going to ask our worship leader, Brother Dick Campbell, if you'll come, close us in a word of prayer, ask God's blessing on the food, and then when you leave here, go right over to our fellowship hall, enjoy some refreshments, congratulate Melissa, words of expression to the children for the great job they did here tonight. Brother Dick.
God has blessed us in so very many ways with the gifts and talents. And we can see another generation rising up, prepared to serve Him and lead Him, lead us and all of us. I'm going to lose this in a minute, guys. Hold on a second. Sorry. Let's pray together. Father in Christ, thank you for these kids. Thank you for the birth, the physical birth that brought them here and the families that have brought us together. Thank you for the spiritual births that are happening in this group of kids. Some, Father, who have already given their hearts to Christ. Others that are looking daily. Thank you for leaders in Sunday school who work diligently to share the message of Christ and the stories in the Bible to point the way to the cross. Thank you for the support that we have in Awanas. Thank you, Father, for the people there that continually put Jesus out front and make that an opportunity for the kids to just to learn more and to get excited about Christ. Thank you for the gift of leaders that we have in music that place the songs of joy in the hearts of these kids. And I pray, Father, through all that is done and everything that we do, Lord, you would raise up a generation of children that would stand strong for the Lord. Bless them, Father, the much work that has been done. Those kids have done so much, and yet you sit up there with a big smile, God, just loving us, each and one. Use them, use us. Bless the food that's here as we gather together in a fellowship. And I pray it in Jesus' name, in the name of your Son, Emmanuel. Amen. God bless you. Food's that way. Food's that way.